So, hi, welcome. I am so happy to be here. So, my name is Joe Hernandez-Kolski. I am half Mexican, half Polish, about as Chicago as you get. Unless we have any Irish Puerto Ricans in the house. And the weird thing is, coming from a mixed background, it's 2014 and people still don't know what to do with that information. So they associate you with food. They're still like, wow, you're Polish and Mexican. What does that give you? A love for kielbasa with a side of frijoles? No, it gives me white privilege with a side of street cred. So I was born Joseph Edwin Kolski. Joseph is my Mexican grandfather. Edwin is my Polish grandfather. The Hernandez was added by my mother. Very early on, she could see I was struggling with my Mexican heritage. Maybe because my Polish grandmother used to introduce me to her friends as, "This is Joey, my Mexican grandson." Till the day that I introduced her as, "This is Charlotte, my racist grandma." Now, my parents, they could see that I was struggling with this part of my identity. They did what all good parents do. They sent me away. Because even though being Mexican was an issue for me, speaking Spanish was so cool to me. The way my grandmother conversed in secrecy with my aunts and uncles in the kitchen, which I witnessed as a child, hiding under the table, thinking I'm able to turn invisible, listening in on their conversations. If only I understood what they're saying. Mom, I want to learn Spanish. Mijo, you want to know the best way? Go live with your tía in Mexico City, where you'll speak it from sunrise to sundown every single day. So for 3 months, I lived in El Distrito Federal, Mexico City, con mi tía y mis primos. I am on my first trip ever without my family. Yes! Señoras y señoras, damas y caballeros, bienvenidos a Primer Landmark en la vida de Joe Hernandez Kolski. I returned with stories of Los Pirámides de Teotihuacan, the sun and the moon pyramids filled with so much history, or the coast of Mexico in Zihuatanejo, where I witnessed the most beautiful sunset ever and prayed to God to please let me fly over the ocean at this moment, and I will go to church every Sunday for the rest of my, well, for a really long time. Or la barbacoa, the barbecue, where I witnessed the unearthing of a dead goat buried, cooking over hot coals underground, the blood dripping off the body and made into soup. ¿Dónde está las hamburguesas? Now, I not only return with this, like, newfound sense of pride, but I just so happen to be 12 years old. I went through puberty down there. Down there meaning Mexico, but yes, also down there. I returned to the United States on my 13th birthday. 3 inches taller, with facial hair and a much deeper voice, I called every girl I knew. "Hey, Julie. It's Joe." "Yeah. Joe Hernandez Kolski." Now, I wish I could say that, you know, one trip, you know, one summer in Mexico and you know who you are, but our identity, as I believe all of ours are, it's a bit more complicated than that. Like, I still, throughout high school, even into college, I still bought into the stereotypes. Like, here I was, listening to somebody's phone go off. I'm this freshman, I'm at Princeton University, this is a big deal for my family. I go to my first Chicano caucus meeting, and I walk right out going, no, they're real Mexicans. Because I still believe that you're only really Mexicano if you are a certain shade of brown, speak Spanish perfectly, and know the lyrics to every Vicente Fernandez song ever sung. Por tu mar. Yeah, that's all I know. So here I was, and that's the weird thing about only being half Latino, is you very often feel like you're not Latino enough. What does that even mean? Is there some dude in some random urban garage somewhere who is the most Latino man in the world? I'm going to show up to his door one day searching for the answers, and he's going to be like, hola, jefe. Wait, let me put my shirt on. Hey, what do you think? I just tattooed the entire Aztec calendar across my back. Siéntate, sit down. Let me just finish airbrushing these two lesbians onto my Chevy lowrider. So you are insecure about your Latino-ness, huh? Edward James Olmos once said to me, the Cylons never asked us what we wanted. Of course, we were on the set of Battlestar Galactica, so in context, it made more sense. I better get ready. I'm going salsa dancing tonight with Sofia Vergara and Eva Longoria and Eva Mendes. I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer Dos Equis. Because, of course, the most interesting man in the world is Latino, right? And, of course, he's played by Jonathan Goldsmith, a Jewish actor from the Bronx. But here's what happened. As I kept going in college, I began to start realizing that these labels are there to be redefined. I started to meet others who were just like me, other Latinos who were just trying to make a difference in the world, just trying to make their parents proud and trying somehow to maintain a healthy level of street cred. And you have never seen anything more absurd than watching two Latino dudes at an Ivy League school try to out-street one another. We'd show up to him and be like, yo, player, what up? Yo, son, what'd you get for last night's problem set? Oh, come on, Joe. All you gotta do is derive the recursive relation, solve for each pi sub k interval, and then renormalize, son. We were trying so hard to be hard at Princeton. Crazy thing is, that's what I was trying to get away from. Like, where I grew up in Chicago, I could have easily joined a gang if I wasn't so heavily involved in dance, poetry, and musical theater. But if I had joined a gang, by now I'd be running at shit differently. We'd have a rival gang member tied to a chair. He'd be like, what you gonna do with that knife? Cut me? And I'd be like, no. I'm gonna make you a vision board. And my sidekick would be like, yeah, Joe, teach this motherfucker about creative visualization. Oh, shit, it's the cops. Boo! Put down the Oprah magazines and motivational posters, Kolsky. Swear to God, the city's turned into one huge dance battle ever since he took over. And there would be this huge gang standoff. And I would step forward.
my God.
That's so much fun. You guys have